Just let me be live on the Facebook. Good evening, friends. Thank you for being here. Today we are going to have this live workshop on mindful meditation. Okay, so I'm going to start some poll before going for the workshop. Do you have a poll over here? So first poll, how many of you know how to do mindful meditation? Okay, so I'm launching this poll. Just participate in the poll. How many of you know how to do mindful meditation? Participate. Everybody should participate. It has to be interactive. If you participate, then you will take a lot of golden nuggets and it will completely transform your life. So I'm ending this poll. So 43% says yes, they know mindful meditation, and 57% says they don't know. Okay. All right. We are going to learn today how to do mindful meditation. Again, I'm going to launch second poll. How many of you want to learn mindful meditation? Really learn and really going to practice it. 100%. Great. Participate. All participate in the poll. Great. 100%. So I have your commitment. Okay. So I have your commitment that you are going to practice it and utilize in your life. And I'm going to teach you how to practice it in your day-to-day activity, each and every moment of your life, and it will completely transform your life. Okay, so I'm going to share my screen again. So today's topic is mindful meditation, and I'd like to thank all of you from bottom of my hand for being here. You might be doing so many things, but you chose to come here, and I would like to thank all of you. So what is today's learning object? So before going into mindful meditation, we are going to clear certain misconception about our well-being and our own self. Okay, so we are gonna delve on the concept of mind, body and soul. Then we are gonna discuss what is the attribute of mind. So these are the causes of our stress, anxiety, depression and unhappiness in our life because of these attributes of minds, and we're going to discuss in detail, because if you know the problem, then you know the solution. Then what is the concept of mindfulness? How to do mindful meditation? Okay, how to practice it? And then when you practice, then how you can utilize and do meditation in each and every activity of your life. So your eating can become mindful meditation, your walking can become mindful meditation, your sleep can become mindful meditation, and your profession, your day-to-day activity, and your talk or your relationship with your partner can become a meditation, and it will completely transform your life. And last, I'm going to discuss about benefit of meditation. So, and at the end of the talk, those who want to take their health to the next level, I'm going to discuss about my community. Okay, so there are certain instructions. Just have pen and pad with you, because you might be learning something which will completely transform your life. And once you finish this workshop, you may forget. Okay, so if you find certain things important, then you should write it down. Second thing, if you have something to be done and it is emergency, so you can leave, because this is a life transforming workshop. So I want your commitment, 100% commitment till the end, because if you don't attend till the end, then you will not get the concept about mindful meditation. Okay. And thousands of people has transformed, including me, their life by doing mindful meditation. If you have any questions, you can write it down in a question and answer section in chat box. It may not be possible, but if you have any questions, then you're going to write it down in a question and answer section. And I'm going to take all these questions after finishing of the session. So somebody has raised the hand. I just want Pratish. I do Vipassana. Great, great. Vivek Sharmaji from Powai. Thank you so much for being here. So great, Vipassana. It is same mindful meditation. So those who do Vipassana, they all know what is mindful meditation. But I'm going to discuss certain, we have to learn. Each and every person's give something new, and we have to take from each and every person. And if you like it, if you find it logical, and then you can incorporate in your life. Vipassana is the best. So I'd like to introduce myself. If I have your permission, should I introduce myself? Write yes in a chat box if you have your permission to introduce myself. Write in the chat box if I have the permission. So, dear friend, I'm basically a pediatric neurologist, and I'm also a wellness coach, stress management consultant, and international bestseller author. Okay, I'd like to share my story with you. 5 years back, okay, I did my MBBS from BJ Medical College and Sachin General Hospital, Pune. I did MD in pediatrics from St. Joseph's Medical College and KM Hospital, Mumbai. And afterward, I did a fellowship in pediatric neurology, and I started practicing. And 5 years back, okay, I came to know that I was completely stressed out and burnt out. Then I stopped, I introspected, and I found that I was in a rat race. Then I started reading lots of books on spirituality, on health, holistic health, self-help book. And while reading this book, then I formulated certain principle. I implemented it, and it completely transformed my life. Okay. So I lost 10 kg of weight. I started looking much younger than my chronological age. My work efficiency improved, and my relationship with my partner, my colleague, tremendously improved. So I started sharing that principle by organizing seminar, webinars, workshop. I did a workshop for Indian Medical Association, Indian Academy of Pediatrics, and a lot of medical college and a lot of cooperation. And thousands of people has benefited from it. So to take this mission forward, I published a book, Oh Stress, Give Me a Break, and it has become a bestseller, international bestseller on Amazon. You can see the Amazon has given a golden year batch on my book. Recently, I published a book, 17 Powerful Secrets to Manage Stress During Corona Pandemic. So I am on a mission to inspire 2 million people about stress, chronic disorder, and how to manage it effectively so as to lead healthy, happy, and more fulfilling life. And in this endeavor, I'm conducting this weekly workshop. Last week, I did a workshop on how to reduce your belly fat without dieting. Okay, a complete guide to healthy eating. And today I'm doing this workshop on mindful meditation. Okay, so we all know that the incidence of chronic disorder, stress is increasing all over the world. And the incidence of non-communicable disorder like obesity, diabetes, heart disease, cancer, psychological disorders are increasing all over the world. In the research, they found that this non-communicable disorder kill 40 million people worldwide. As far as India is concerned, it kill 4.8 million people. due to this non-communicable disorders. And treating these non-communicable disorders is quite expensive affair. In the research, they found that to treat these disorders, the world will require $47 trillion from 2010 to 2013. And for India, it will require $4.5 trillion. Okay, so the cost is humongous and huge. Okay, we cannot afford to spend money to treat this disorder. The only solution is to prevent this disorder. And that's why I'm on a mission to educate people about attaining holistic health. And why these disorders are increasing? There are many causes. The most important cause is stress. Other causes are pollution, then sedentary lifestyle, changing in diet. So, and to add fuel to the fire, now there is a corona pandemic. Billions of people has been affected by all over the world. Millions of people has lost their life. Millions of people has lost their job. There is an atmosphere of stress, anxiety, hopelessness, and depression all over. We don't know what is going to happen in next week. Okay. So, how to deal with this chronic as well as this acute problem? Mind you, the humanity has undergone this pandemic, and this humanity has overcome and came out victoriously, and we are going to come out this pandemic victoriously. This too shall pass, okay? But we have to keep ourselves physically as well as mentally fit to navigate this challenging time. And I'm gonna teach you how to navigate this challenging time through this various workshop. I'd like to share one story with you. Once there was a kingdom and there was a queen. She had a very beautiful garden. You can see the beautiful garden. There were very beautiful trees, roses and all. People from faraway places used to come and visit that garden. Unfortunately, one day the queen became ill. She has to go to other city for her treatment, and she was very worried about her garden. Her 10-year-old son came and said, "Mother, please don't worry about garden. Take care of your health and I'll take care of the garden." So the mother went away. And when she came back after 1 month, she straight away went to the garden. But she became very unhappy seeing the sorry state of affair. All the trees were dried up. There were no leaves. There were no flowers. She scolded her son. But the son said, "Mother, please don't scold me. I used to work very hard from morning to evening. Till night, I used to clean each and every leaves, and I used to give water to each and every leaves and flower. But I don't know what has happened." Mother said, "My dear son, the life of the tree is not in the leaves, flower, but the life of the tree is in the root. Okay. If you have taken care of the root, if you have given the water to the root, the tree would have taken care of itself, and it would have leaves, flower, and fruits." Okay, so my dear friends, we have forgotten our root. Okay, we are not only body and mind, we are body, mind, and soul. We have forgotten our root, our soul. That's why the tree of our life has dried up. There are no leaves, there is no flower. There is a lot of stress, unhappiness, anxiety, and depression because we have forgotten our root, our soul. Okay, so I'm gonna clarify certain concept about body, mind, and soul. So our body is natural. Soul is natural, but the mind is given by the society, by conditioning. When we are born, our heart is strong. We are soul. And the characteristic of soul is peace, happiness, intellect. But as we go older, because of the conditioning, our head, our mind becomes strong, and we forget our heart, our soul. The mind acts like a curtain, and it separates us from our soul. And because of this mind, there is such a stress and anxiety and unhappiness in our life. And if you want to become happy, to go to your original state, then you have to get rid of this mind and to reach a non-mind state. Okay. And we have to nourish our soul because its characteristic is peace and happiness. Now somebody will say, if we go in a state of no mind, then we'll become mad. No. Okay. The mind is our servant and soul is our master. We have forgotten our master. This servant has become our master. Okay. The soul, the characteristic of soul is peace, happiness, intellect. And we have forgotten it because of the curtain of the mind. And I'd like to explain with the help of analogy. For example, if there is water in a pond, there's a clean water in a pond, and it has a contact with the sunlight. But after some time, if we do not care of the pond, then the grass, the moss, the dirt will accumulate over the pond, the clean water, and it will prevent the contact of sun to the clean water because of this dirt which is accumulated on this pond. Similarly, we, the soul is like a clean water and the dirt is like a mind, and it is preventing our contact with the Supreme Soul. If we want to have a contact with our Supreme Soul, then we have to get rid of this mind. And this is done with the help of mindful meditation. Saint Kabir has said, "Ghungat ka pat khol re, to ko pihu milonge. Ghat ghat mein wo sai ramta katuk vachan mat bol re. Shun mahal mein diyan barile asan so mat dol re. Jagu jugut surang mahal mein piya payo anmol re. Kahe Kabir anand bhayo bajat anat dol re." Okay, so what the Saint Kabir says, ghungat ka pat khol re to ko pihu milenge. So ghungat means we have put a kind of a curtain between us and pihu, means God. You can call it a Supreme Soul, Paramatma, or anything. Okay, so this mind has created a curtain between us and Supreme Soul. We have forgotten our soul. That's why there is so much of darkness inside us. If we take a light in the form of mindful meditation or any kind of meditation in a temple inside, it will enlighten that temple and we will see our God, our Paramatma, our Supreme Soul, and we will be happy, which we will be happy, which would be eternal. What Kabir say? Bajat anath dholre. Means anath means eternal. So this mindful meditation will take care of our root and our life would be full of peace and happiness. So I'd like to share some attributes about a mind, and these attributes are very important. If you know how this mind tricks us and causes so much of problem, then we will come to know the solution. So till this, all are with us. All are with me. Write in the chat box. Yes. Yes. Write in the chat box. Yes. If you're with me. Thank you so much, Sandeepji, for your feedback. Thank you, Vivekji. Thank you so much for your feedback. Thank you, Kishoreji. Am I audible and visible? If there is anything, you can write in the chat box. Okay. Thank you so much. So we are going to discuss the attributes of mind. Okay. The first attribute is mind is nothing but collection of thoughts. In the research, it's found that 50 to 60 thoughts enter in our mind every day. Okay. And these thoughts are usually useless. Chatter keeps on happening in our mind. And because of these thoughts, we are drained. Our energy is drained. We are not able to concentrate in our job, or if we are with our wife or our family member, we are not able to concentrate because our mind is like monkey. It is hopping from one thought to another thoughts, and 50 to 60 thoughts enter in our mind. Okay. So I'd like to share one story with you. Once Guru Nanak ji went to visit one Nawab, a king. the nawab was about to offer the prayer. It's called as namaz. Okay, so the nawab requested Guru Nanak ji, can you participate in the prayer? The Guru Nanak ji said, yes, I will participate in prayer, provided that you offer a prayer. So the nawab and the priest started offering namaz. They were offering namaz, but they saw that Guru Nanak ji was not offering the prayer. The nawab and the priest become very angry. When they finished the prayer, they went and asked Nanak ji, you said that you're going to offer a prayer, but you didn't offer the prayer. Nanak ji said, I told you, I had a precondition that you, if you are going to offer the prayer, I'm going to offer a prayer. But nawab, when you are offering a prayer, you are thinking that, oh, my horse has become old and tomorrow I'm going to go to a market and buy a good horse. And you are imagining about the color and other attributes about horse. Listening to this, this nawab become very, he has a shame, and then he put his head down. He asked the priest, priest, though you are offering the prayer, but you are thinking about your produce in your field, how you are going to cut it, how you are going to sell it in the market. Again, listening to this, the priest also put his head down because he was thinking the same thing while offering prayer. Okay, so we have a lot of thoughts when we are doing something, our mind is somewhere else, and it reduces our efficiency. Also, it affects our relationship. In the research, they asked, this research was conducted in US, and they asked the people what you are doing, okay, and whether you are in the present moment and how you are feeling. So in the research, they found that 47% of the people are not in the present moment, okay, and those who are in the present moment were happy, and those who were, whose mind were wandering, they were unhappy. Okay, so this mind wandering, these thoughts create a lot of stress in our life. The second attributes of mind is ego. Ego means aging God out. Saint Kabir has said, "Main jab tha tab hari nahi, jab hari hai main nahi." Okay, so when I was there, there was no God. When there was ego, there was no God. When I get rid of this ego, and there was only God. Okay, so this ego creates a lot of problem in our life. On a lighter note, once a Mullah Nasruddin, he is a 90-year-old, he summoned his son who is 60-year-old, and he says, I'm gonna get married. Son said, you are 90-year-old, you are on the verge of dying, and whom you're gonna get married? Mullah Nasruddin said, I'm gonna get married a girl next door, who is living in next door. His son said, she's only 18-year-old. The Mullah Nasruddin said, then what? When I married your mother, she was 18-year-old. Okay, so he's not looking at his fault, his age. Okay, then his son said, marrying at this age is extremely dangerous for your health. It may lead to death. Mullah Nasruddin said, if she dies, then I will marry other girl. Okay, so this person is not finding fault himself. He's finding fault with other people. And this ego creates a lot of problem. Because of this ego, there is a lot of tension in our life. And it is also called as aging girlfriend out, aging your partner out. Okay, so this mind is full of ego. Third attribute is mind thinks in logical way. It thinks in pros and cons, then takes certain decision. And we all know, we always find that we have taken a bad decision because of the mind. On a lighter note, once there was a king. His son became 21-year-old. He summoned his minister and says, find a very beautiful 18-year wife for my son. A good 18-year beautiful girl. The minister goes after 1 month when he couldn't find a suitable girl for this prince. The king become very angry. He summoned the minister again and says, if you don't find next day, I'm gonna punish you. The next day, this minister brings two girls. The king said, why you got the two girls? And they're very small. The minister said, I couldn't find a beautiful girl who is 18 year old. I got these two 9 year old beautiful girls. Okay, so he was thoughting a mathematical way. So our mind is logical way, but the life is not logic. It is not mathematics. Okay, there are so many other things. The next attribute of the mind is it's complex. Okay, it's very complex. In Greek, the meaning of personality is the meaning of personality is persona, like mask. We have wear a mask in front of us. We are somebody inside and we try to project to other world something else. Okay, so that create a kind of a tension because we are somebody else and we are projecting to the society as somebody else, and this creates a kind of a tension, a stress in our life. Okay, I would like to share one story with you. Once an old and young monk were traveling on their way to their ashram, and there was a river in between their ashram on their way. When they reached the bank of the river, they found that one beautiful girl was trying to cross the river, but she was unable to cross the river. This old monk thought, should I help her to cross the river? But he said, he has vowed the vow of celibacy, and he has vowed not to touch any woman. And if he touch, he will go to hell. But again, the second thought came in her mind that she's so beautiful. Okay, so he was thinking about hell and heaven. Then he found that the other young monk took this girl on his shoulder and helped her cross the river. This old monk become very angry. The reason of anger were two. First of all, he thought that this young monk has broken the rule of the ashram. And second thing, he has missed the opportunity to touch the beautiful girl. So when they were about to reach the ashram, this old monk said to the young monk, I'm very angry at you. You have broken the rule. I'm going to tell the chief master of the ashram about the things which you have done. The young monk said, what I have done? The old monk said, you have carried that girl on your shoulder. And it is against our rule. The young monk said, sir, I have carried her and I have left her at the bank of river, and you are still carrying her on your shoulder. Okay, so this young monk was simple, subtle. He just helped her to carry. This old monk was complex. He was somebody inside and he was trying to project outside. These kind of things create a lot of tension in our life. The next attribute of mind is the mind is ignorant. He's under influence. We are under the darkness. So in the Hindu ideology, we have three attributes: sattvagun, rajasgun, and tamogun. Okay, so this sattvagun is that of awareness, the rajas is that of ego, and this tamas is ignorance. Our mind is ignorant. So it is said that the ignorance is darkness and the awareness is a light. Okay, so I'd like to share one story with you. Once Mulla Nasruddin took his friend in the wine shop and he was teaching his friend how much alcohol you should drink. And he was telling his friend, see, in the next table, there are four people. If you start seeing eight people, then you have to think that it's sufficient and you have to stop drinking the alcohol. The friend said, but there are only two people. Okay, so Mulla Nasruddin was already under the influence of alcohol. So the alcohol, when somebody is under the influence of alcohol, then their consciousness goes away. Similarly, when we are under the influence of ignorance, darkness, we do not see what is there in our life. And that is the attributes of mind. The next attribute that the mind has a lot of attachment. Okay, we have attachment to our relation, means our wife, children's, our job, or our position. And when something happens against our expectation, then it creates a problem. So does it that you should not have attachment to your relations or your job, your status? No. You should love your partner, you should love your children, you should love, but it has to be unconditional love, because we have some precondition. If I love, then you have to do according to my wish, and that creates a problem. And this is the attribute of mind. And the last attribute is the mind is discontented. Okay, it's never satisfied. On a lighter note, once Mullah Nasruddin read a news in a newspaper. So in the newspaper, he read an ad given by a rich man, and the rich man wanted to get his daughter married. So he reached the Mullah Nasruddin goes to meet the rich man. The rich man welcomes Mullah Nasruddin and say, "See, this is my 30-year-old daughter. If you marry her, I will give you 10 lakh rupees as a dowry. This is my second daughter. She is 40-year-old. If you marry her, I'll give 20 lakh as a dowry. And this is a third daughter. She is 45-year-old. If you marry her, I'll give 30 lakh as a dowry. Mullah Nasruddin thinks, "Oh, as the age increase, the dowry increase." Okay. Mullah Nasruddin asks this rich man, "Do you have any daughter who is 100-year-old? Okay, so our mind is never contented. We want lot of things, and not satisfied what we have. And it creates this kind of stress and anxiety. So these are the attribute of mind, and this, because of this attribute, we are unhappy. So now we'll go to the concept about mindfulness. So dear friends, all are with me. How are you finding this thing? Write in the chat box. How are you finding this workshop? You got the attributes about mind, why there's so much of stress and anxiety and unhappiness in our life? Write in the chat box if you got the attributes about the mind. Thank you, Vivekji, very captivating. Thank you so much for your feedback. Write in the chat box how you are finding till this time. Good. Thank you, Kishoreji. Rajas is Sattvagun, Rajogun, and Tamasgun. Okay. The Sattvagun is there is awareness. Okay. There is no good, no bad, only awareness. And the mindful meditation help you to find this Sattvagun. Rajasgun is Rajas means the character, the attributes of the king. The king is having Rajas Gun. He has an egoistic gun. And the Tamas is ignorant, lazy. Okay. So write in the chat box how are you finding this workshop. Now we are going to go to the mindfulness now. Because you have to get your concept about your mind clear. Because of these attributes of this mind, we are having so much a problem in our life. So now we are going to go to mindfulness. So what is mindfulness? Mindfulness is accepting life and living in a present moment. Okay. With awareness. The meaning about mindfulness is present moment and awareness. Awareness about present moment. Paying attention to the present moment. Taking time to see what is happening around you in a non-judgmental way, rather than focusing on past or future with a total acceptance. Okay. So just having awareness about the present moment and without judgment. That is the most important thing. And it involves being aware of each thoughts, each feeling, any sensation that comes to you, and accepting it without involvement and non-judgmental way. Okay. So being aware of about your thoughts, your sensation, your feeling, and without any judgment and involvement. Dear friends, we are either in the past or we are always worried about our future. And that's the main cause of stress. We are not in the present moment. We are always repentant about our past things, and we are always worried about our future. On a lighter note, once a politician went to visit, goes to a salon to cut his hair. The barber asked the politician, "Sir, what happened in the last election 1 year back? Why did you lose that election?" The politician narrated his ordeal. But he said, stop. Every time when I come to cut my hair, you ask me the same question and you make me angry. You know, I have lost it miserably. Why do you ask again and again when I come to cut the hair?" The barber said, "Sir, when you become angry, your hair straighten up and it is very easy to cut." Okay. So even if the thing has happened in our past, but we are again and again angry about the things which has happened in the past, and it ruins our present. And we are always worried about our future. Mark Twain has said, "My life was full of a lot of worry. Most of things didn't happen." I'd like to share one story with you. Once there was a couple and they wanted to visit their relative in another village. But there was a problem. There was a river in between two villages, and the bridge over that village was in a very bad state. It was about to collapse. So they were worried whole night that if they walk on that bridge, the bridge breaks, they will fall in the river and they may die. So whole night they worried how to cross that river. But as that was an emergent thing, they have to go and cross that, go to that village to meet their relative. When in the next morning they went to the river, they found that the new bridge was built on the river. Okay. So unnecessarily they were worried about the future. And similarly, we are worried about our future. Past is a history, future is the mystery. Present is a gift. That's why it's called as present. Okay. So as we are in past and we are worried about future, we just miss the present. And mind you, the present is the truth. Okay, there is no past and there is no future. It's all illusion. The present is the truth. And we just do not in the present moment. And that's why there's so much of stress and unhappiness in our life. Just give me 1 minute. Somebody has come. Sorry for the interruption. The laundryman has come there. Second thing, we always have a judgment, whatever thoughts, whatever things happen in our life. This is good, this is bad, this should not happen, this should happen this way, this should not happen that way. We are always judgmental, and that creates a problem in our life. For example, if you're watching India-Pakistan match, if you are Indian, then if India wins, you are happy. If India lost, you are unhappy. Okay. So if you watch a man, if you watch a match as a third person without having any expectation and any judgment, you can enjoy the match as a sportman. But we always have a judgment about anything, any about our thoughts, our feeling, or our sensation in our body. We give label, this is good, this is bad, and that creates a problem in our life. And mindful meditation teaches you how to live the life in a non-judgmental way. Now, the mistake about meditation, the people thinks that the meditation is concentration. But the meditation, especially the mindful meditation, is not concentration. You don't have to become empty, or you should not have any goal about meditation. What happens because of this concentration? For example, if you are sitting for meditation and there is some noise, somebody calls, somebody rings the bell, what it creates? It creates a lot of tension, because you are having goal in your mind that I'm going meditation, I should empty my mind, I should concentrate, and something happen which is not according to your wish, then it creates a tension. So instead of giving a peace, happiness, the meditation creates a tension in your life. Have you noticed this? So meditation is not concentration. Meditation is awareness. Because if you fight with something, if you think that this noise should not come, this there shouldn't, the people should not blow their horn, people should not talk, then that creates a tension. Okay, so meditation is not concentration, it is awareness. Now, how to do mindful meditation exercise? Now, first I am going to discuss and explain to you, and then we are all going to practice. Okay, we are going to practice and we are going to experience the peace. So this mindful meditation exercise you can do in sitting position, you can do on lying down position, whatever position you feel comfortable with, but you should do it. Okay, if you're sitting, then it's good, but you can do it in a lying down position as well. When you're sitting, you have to just erect your back, okay, and you have to just rest your hand on your thighs. Then you have to just close your eyes slowly. You have to close your eyes, and then you have to give instruction to your mind that my body is relaxing. Okay, so we have a lot of stress in our life, whole day we are working, there's a lot of stiffness in a joint muscle, and that creates pain and soreness. So you're gonna give instruction to your mind, because your mind is your servant. So my body is relaxing. You can do it for a few 1 minute. Then you have to give instruction that my breathing is relaxing. What happens when we are stressed? We breathe fast. When we are at peace, we breathe very slow. Okay, so you have to just breathe naturally, and you have to give instruction that your breathing is relaxing. Then after 1 minute, you have to give instruction that my mind is relaxing. There are a lot of chatters occurring in your mind, so you have to just say in your mind that my mind is relaxing. Okay, so this setup means after giving instruction to your body that your body is relaxing, your breathing is relaxing, your mind is relaxing, then you have to focus your attention at your nostril, at the tip of your nostril. Okay, the air coming in, the air going out, the air coming in, the air going out. Okay, so you have to just observe your breath at the nostril, the sensation it creates, the sound it produces. You have to just be aware of the sensation and the sound it produces when the air enters at your nostril and when it leaves your nostrils. Okay, so air coming in, air going out. So this is the mindful meditation. Okay, it's very simple. Just having awareness of your breath at the nostril, air coming in, air going out. Now, while doing this, the thought will occur in your mind. Our mind is like monkey. We have seen the attributes of our mind. So when you recognize that you are in thought, I'm thinking something and I was doing meditation and I have gone somewhere else. Now, when you come to know that you are in some thought, then you have to bring back your attention at the nostril. Okay. So this is the second step. That's very important. You don't have to become thoughtless or empty in your mind. Okay. You have to just observe your breath. And when you think that you are in some thought, then you have to bring back your attention at the nostril. That's it. Okay. Because when you come to know that you are in thought, it is also awareness and it is also meditation. The mindful meditation is awareness. Whether you are aware about your the breathing at your nostril or you are aware about your, you are in a thought. So even if you are aware about that you are having some thought, you have to bring back your attention at nostril, and this is the mindful meditation. So many people think that I'm doing mindful meditation, but I'm not getting the result. So I ask them, what kind of result do you want? This is when I sit in a meditation, I have a lot of thoughts in the mind. No, having thoughts and you being aware of it is also a mindful meditation. So when you have a awareness about your thought, you have to bring back your attention at nostril, and that is mindful meditation, and it creates a magic. Okay. So you don't have to have any goal, but the only thing is awareness of your breath at your nostril. And if you have some thoughts, bring back your attention at your nostril. Your nostril is your anchor. For example, you are sitting at the bank of river and you are just observing the water flowing in the river. Okay, you are just aware and observing the water. You are not preventing the water entering in the river and you are not flowing with the water. You are just observing it. That is mindful meditation. You are like a sky. Okay, and you are just observing the clouds. The clouds are like thoughts. Some clouds may be dark, some cloud may be white. Means some thought may be good, some thoughts may be bad. They will come, but you will be like a sky. You will just observe these clouds coming in and going. You are not giving any judgment that this is black cloud, this is dark cloud, this is white cloud. So similarly, we are not going to label any thoughts entering in our mind, whether it's good thought, whether it's a bad thought. It is, you are just observing that thought and letting it go away of its own. Because if you don't give attention to anything, it just disappears. So if you don't give any attention to your thoughts, you will become thoughtless, and it will occur over a period of time after practicing. So the first thing is becoming thoughtless, and it will occur over a period of time. Till that time, you have to just observe your breath at nostril. And when you have thoughts in your mind, you have to bring back your attention at the nostril. Then also, if you have any sensation in your body, there may be some tingling, there may be some numbness. Okay, you have to just observe that sensation. You should not label that sensation, whether it is good sensation, whether it is a bad sensation. You have to just be aware of that sensation. And if you find that there is a lot of numbness, you can sit, you can just walk for a while and you can come back and sit. Okay. And while walking, you can be doing meditation if you are aware about your walking. So when you're sitting, just observe your breath at nostril, bring back your attention at nostril, just be aware about any sensation which is there in your body. And this is mindful meditation. Okay, so it's so simple. You don't have to do it. You don't have to do anything. Just being aware, awareness of your breath at the nostril, air coming in and air going out. And with a practice, you will become a thoughtless. And when you will become a thoughtless, you will experience a kind of peace which you have never experienced. Okay, so now we are going to do this exercise. I'm going to stop sharing the screen and we are going to do mindful meditation. Somebody said my voice is breaking. So is it that my am I audible? Just write in the chat box whether I'm audible. Somebody said I'm not on screen. Can you see me on a screen? Thank you so much. Okay, now so I'm audible as well as visible. So now my voice is not breaking. I think my voice is not breaking. So Vivekji said Dhobi did not create a tension. Yes, it didn't create a tension. Thank you so much for the feedback. Vivekji said we need to remember to be gentle and polite to ourselves. Wandering off is a natural when we are beginner. That's the most important thing. We have to be gentle. Okay, we are not doing anything. We are not doing any concentration. We are just sitting and just observing our breath. We have to be gentle with ourselves. Even if we have some thoughts in our mind, bring back our attention and don't be angry at yourself that you are having thought in your mind. Okay, being aware of having thoughts, that is also meditation. Awareness is a meditation. So now I'm visible and audible, I think. Okay, so now we are going to practice this mindful meditation. I'm going to give some instruction to you and you are going to do it live. Okay, so just close your eyes. Okay, just if you're sitting, just erect your back and just close your eyes. Slowly, slowly, you close your eyes. Your eyes are closing. Your eyes are closing. Your eyes are closing. Now you're going to give instruction to your body that my body is relaxing. So you're going to do it in mind only. You're not going to do it loudly, but you're just going to give instruction to your body that my body is relaxing. 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 If there are any tension, if there are any tightness in your muscle, in your joint, just be aware of it. Don't label it whether it is good or whether it is bad. Just relax yourself. Whole day, we are working hard. We are under a lot of stress because of deadline, because of so much of things which we have to do. And it creates a lot of tightness in our body. It creates ache, pain, soreness. Just relax your body. Just relax it. And even if there is a tightness, just observe it and let it be. Just observe it in a non-judgmental way. Now you're going to give instruction to your mind that my breathing is relaxing. My breathing is relaxing. My breathing is relaxing. My breathing is relaxed. My breathing is relaxing. My breathing is relaxing. My breathing is relaxing. My breathing is relaxing. What happens when we are angry, when we are under stress, we breathe very fast. When our mind is calm, in peace, it breathes very slowly. So just relax, just relax, just take a very deep breath, very slow breath, just relax. Give instruction that my breathing is relaxing. Now bring back your attention to your mind that my mind is relaxing. We have so much of thought occurring in our mind whole day. Just observe your mind, just say, my mind is relaxing. My mind is relaxed. My mind is relaxing. My mind is relaxing. My mind is relaxed. So this is a setup. Now your body, your breathing, your mind is relaxed now. Now we will start a meditation. So you're going to observe your breath at the nostril. Okay. Now you are not going to manipulate your breath. It's going to happen naturally. Whatever way your breathing is occurring, let it happen. And just observe your breath at nostril. Your breathing, your air is entering at the nostril. Just observe it. Just observe and being aware of the sound it produced, the sensation it produced. Again, when you exhale the air, just be aware of the air leaving your nostril, the sound it produced, the sensation it produced. So you are just observing the breath. Now you might be having any thought in your mind. Just relax, be gentle to yourself. Don't be angry. Bring back your attention at the nostril. Your nostril is anchor. Just observe your breath. Even if you are aware of your breath, you are in meditation. Even if you are aware that you are in thoughts, again, you are doing meditation. You are successful. Okay. So just have awareness of breathing at the nostril. If you have any thought, again, bring back your attention at nostril. Just experience the air, the sensation it produced at your nostril. Just observe and experience the sound it produced when it enters and when it leaves. When it enters, when it leaves. If there is any tingling, numbness, you can just relax. There is no hard and fast rule that you have to sit, even if there is tingling and numbness. You can sit, you can stand, and be just aware of whatever you are doing. That's the mindful meditation. So if there is a tingling, numbness, just observe it, just be aware of it. Just don't label anything to it, whether it is good or bad. If you have any thoughts, bring back your attention at the nostril. Your nostril is anchor. Just be gentle to yourself. Don't be angry that you are having thoughts. It's okay, no problem. Now we are going to end this meditation practice session. Just slowly, slowly open your eyes. Slowly, slowly open your eyes. Slowly open your eyes. Slowly open your eyes. Okay. And just be aware of your surrounding. So, how did you find it? So Gopalji said, when I do meditation, most probably I felt that time I'm in the air. I feel that 2-3 feet out of floor. Yes, yes, yes. So Rajeshji has asked, do we have to take a deep breath through nostril as in passive, can't feel air in the nostril? No, you should not manipulate your breathing. You don't have to manipulate your breathing. You have to just observe your breath. Initially, you will not feel that you are not in the, you are not able to feel the sensation of the air, but you are aware that you are taking your breath. And if you are not aware about your breathing, then you can be aware of your abdomen. Okay. Because when we inhale, we expand the abdomen. Abdomen comes out. When we exhale, it goes back. So, if you're not finding comfortable giving awareness at the nostril, you can be aware of your abdomen. When we inhale, the abdomen goes out. When we exhale, the abdomen goes in. You can have your focus or your awareness on your chest as well. Okay. So even if you are not comfortable with breathing, there are other methods. You can have awareness about your chest, your abdomen. There are other methods that you body scan method. You can be aware about your sensation. There is called as body scan. You can start from your feet and go upward, and you just observe the feeling. What feeling is there in the feet? What feeling is there in the calf, thigh, abdomen, chest? There's other kind of meditation that you can listen some sound and you just observe that sound. So there are many methods. Okay, there are many methods you can do the meditation. Okay, there should not be any fixation. The only important thing is awareness. Awareness. You can have awareness about your breathing. You can have awareness about your chest movement or your abdomen movement. Okay. Kishoreji said, I went to sleep. Yes, it's possible because you become so relaxed. Okay, so you become so relaxed, then you can go to sleep. And I'm going to discuss that. If you do this method while sleeping and you fall asleep, your whole sleep become mindful meditation. So don't worry. Congratulations. If you go to sleep, your sleep will become meditation, provided that you follow the steps which I have explained. Okay. Vivekji said, stress busting experience, relax lighter. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Kishoreji, for your feedback. Thank you so much. So Rajeshji has asked, how could we use this meditation through the day as thoughts are always coming through the day? So relax. Now I'm going to discuss this, how to bring this meditation to each and every moment of your life. Okay. Now So Vivekji said being present in a present is very enjoyable experience. Thank you so much. So now this mindful meditation which we have done, it's only mindful meditation practice. Okay. It is just to make you aware what is the mindfulness. Now you have to take this experience to each and every moment of your life. For example, your eating can become mindful meditation. So how? When you are on a table for eating, you have to just switch off the TV. You have to just observe the fruit, the food which has been served there, the color, various variety of the food which has been served. Then you have to experience its fragrance. Okay. When you touch the food, we have to experience the texture of the food. When you put your food in the mouth, you have to experience the taste of the food. When the food enters and goes in your gut, you have to observe and experience the moment that food does when it navigates your abdomen. Okay. What happens when we eat, we are watching television, we are just eating, and doing so, we overeat. Second thing, we do not experience what we are eating. Okay. So if you want to enjoy your food, your eating can become mindful meditation if you be just aware about your eating. Now, when you go for walking, your walking can become mindful meditation. While walking, you have to just observe the physicality of your feet touching the ground, the sensation, the sound it produces, the wind you are experiencing, the greenery you are seeing, the chirping of the birds you are listening. You are just observing it, and you are walking, you are jogging can become mindful meditation. Now somebody will say, I don't have a time to do mindful meditation. Okay. When you go to sleep, when you lie down on a bed, you follow the steps I have told you, means just observe your breath or your chest or abdomen. Okay. And bring back your attention at nostril. And while doing it, when you fall asleep, your whole sleep will become mindful meditation. Okay. Now the concept is clear. Even if you fall asleep while doing this step, your sleep become mindful meditation. And when you get up in the morning, you would be refreshed. You have a lot of energy in the morning and you will not have any bad dreams. Okay. So your sleep can become mindful meditation. If you are driving, what happens when we are driving? We are having a lot of thoughts in our mind, and that is the cause of a lot of accidents. If you are aware that you are driving, you are just observing everything, then there would be no lapse in your concentration and you will drive properly. You will enjoy your driving properly. For example, you are traveling in a train, especially in Mumbai, there's so much of time spent on traveling. When you are traveling, you're sitting in a train, just close your eyes, just observe your breath. That's it. There would be a lot of commotion. Let it be. Just accept the commotion. If you do not fight with that commotion, then your travel to the train can become meditation. You're in a traffic jam. Okay. You're that traffic jam can become meditation. Just observe your breath. Just observe other people around. Just don't give any label, no judgment that always there is a traffic. Okay. India is such a country full of traffic. It's so bad. It creates kind of a tension. But if you accept it and utilize that time to do meditation, your traffic jam can become meditation. If you are brushing your teeth, your brushing of teeth become meditation. You just observe and experience the sensation your brush produced in the gum. Your brushing can become meditation. When you get up in the morning, just now, first thing, when you get up in the morning, you have always thought, hey, what I have to do? Then it produces a lot of stress. What I have done yesterday? Just relax. Just observe your breath when you wake up. Just go at window. Just observe the tree, the greenery, the birds. Because we are just living our life mechanically. Okay, we are not observing the beauty of the nature. Just observe the sunrise. Just enjoy it. Just observe for the sake of it. When you travel, you just observe. When you reach your office, just sit. Just observe your breath for 2 minutes and start working. And when you're working, just focus all your attention in a present moment. Just don't think about your home or anything else. Then your work efficiency will skyrocket. It will increase tremendously. Okay. So your work will become meditation. Or if you're working continuously after 1 or 2 hours, just take a break. Just close your eyes. Just observe your breath for 2 minutes. Short 2 minute mindful meditation will re-energize you. And again, you will be able to focus your attention in the present moment in your job. When you reach your home, just observe, give full attention, full focus to what your wife is saying. Because when wife is saying something, you have some, you are thinking about some deadlines in your job, and it creates a problem in your relation. So talking to your wife can become meditation. Just observe, just listen carefully. Okay. Your talk to your wife can become mindful meditation. So this way, you have to incorporate mindful meditation in each and every aspect of your life. And mind you, if you do this, your life will be completely changed. Your work efficiency will increase. You will raise the corporate ladder. You will be successful in your business. Your relationship with your spouse, your partner, your colleagues will improve. Okay. So each and every moment you have to just, when you are busy in your day-to-day life, when you are aware that, hey, I am just leading the life mechanically, I'm somewhere else, bring back your attention to the job, what you're doing in the present moment. And that would become meditation. So somebody has asked, this practice of 5 minutes, 10 minutes, it is just to make you aware what is mindful meditation, what is meditation. And you have to do it regularly, this practice, maybe 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever time you are comfortable. But take the cue from this practice and utilize for each and every moment of your life. Is it clear? Right? So, Rajaji said, does it make you complacent and not plan for future? Okay. Now, what happens? We are always driven by our goal. But in Gita, Lord Krishna said, karmanya vadhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. So what does it mean? You have to become a karma yogi. So what do you mean by karma yogi? You have to have a goal, a lot of goal in your life. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam has said that you should have a burning desire in yourself. You should have a desire in your life. If you have a burning desire, then God will give wings to your fire and it will illuminate yourself and whole world. So you should have a big plan in your life. You should have a plan for your personal life, your professional, your social, and your spiritual life. But once you set the goal, then you have to give your attention to the action, to the present moment. Because if you have your eyes always on your goal and you're not giving any attention to the present moment and the things which is required to fulfill that goal, then you will be always unsuccessful. So have a big goal in your life, but give attention to your present moment. Take the action. So you have had a long-term goal. So you divided it into short-term goal. Now you're going to take action to achieve that goal. And while achieving that goal, you have to be mindful of that action. You have to give 100%. You have to be there 100%. That's why if you do that, you will achieve whatever goal you have set. But if you have set a goal and you are always have your eyes on goal and not on efforts, you would be unsuccessful. In a research, it is asked, what is the number one stress in the job? It is said, they said ki it is the result of anything in the job. So we are always stressed about the result. Don't stress about result. Be mindful about what action you are taking to achieve that result. And if you do it, you will achieve that result. So you should have a big goal, but be mindful about the action you take while achieving that goal. Be a karma yogi. And what happens? You should, it's a spiritual, okay, you have the right to do the job. Lord Krishna says, you have just right. You have not right for the fruits. Okay, it is at God's hand. So you have right to do action. You have to take the action. And if you take action with awareness, then you will be always successful. So whatever fruit you get, you have to just give it to the God and be thankful for the God. Then you would lead a very helpful and very happy life. Okay, so I'm clear now that you should have a goal in the life. Rajiji has asked, please share your thought on how to forget the past and forgive yourself for the mistake. Thank you so much. Now, we are always repentant on the things which we have done in the past, and that creates a problem and spoil our present. I would like to share one story with you. Once the four people were carrying a boat on their shoulder in their village, and they were carrying whole day. Now the people asked, why are you carrying that boat on your shoulder? Okay, the place of the boat is in the river. The people said, this boat has saved us from the storm, and as a gratitude, we are carrying on our shoulder. But what happens while carrying that load on the shoulder? They will not able to do the work. Yes, the boat has saved them. You can thank them, but you cannot carry that boat, that burden on your shoulder whole your life. So if you have done any mistake in the past, then you have to first forgive yourself. You have to just forgive, and you have to just forget about your past. It will keep on hounding you, but just observe it for the sake of it. Just don't give any judgment, any meaning to it, and learn from your mistake and just forget and forgive yourself, and be mindful about the present. Okay, if you are all your awareness in the present moment, then you will not have any thoughts about your past. So I think it's clear for you about the past. So I'm gonna now share what are the advantages of mindful meditation. Now there are 4,000 studies done across the globe on mindful meditation. It is one of the hottest topic being studied on mindful meditation. They are bringing the monk from Tibet, putting them in a MRI machine. They are doing the structural MRI. They are doing functional MRI. They are doing a lot of tests. And there are a lot of papers on the benefits of mindful meditation. And to name few, I'm going to enumerate the benefits. In the research, it's found that those who do regular mindful meditation, there is a reduced oxygen consumption. There is increased blood supply to your heart, so your heart becomes strong. There is a deeper level of physical relaxation. The meditation reduces anxiety attack by lowering the level of blood lactate, helps in chronic diseases like allergies, arthritis, reduces premenstrual symptoms, helps in post-operative healing. You can heal yourself fast, enhance the immune system. Now, immunity booster is now the talk of the town today because of the corona pandemic. So if you want to reduce the activity of virus, enhance and boost your immunity, do mindful meditation and be mindful about whatever activity you're doing. It enhances your energy, strength and vigor. It helps to in weight loss. It reduces free radical. There's a less tissue damage. This free radical, there's a fight between, at a cellular level, there's a fight going on between free radical and antioxidant. If free radical increases, there is a disease. It improves flow of air to the lung, resulting in easier breathing. Now again, in corona, the most common organ which is affected is lung, and the most problem is a decrease in saturation. So if you do mindful meditation, you will reduce your stress and you will increase your oxygenation. It decreases the aging process, okay? Prevented, slowed, and controlled pain of chronic disease, and it may help to reduce the headache and migraine. So it's very helpful. Those who are suffering from migraine, do mindful meditation and you'll get lesser attack and you will be able to navigate that headache. Greater orderliness of the brain functioning. So there are different parts of brain and they're working differently. And that's why there's so much of stress. And whenever you take any decision, you find that it is always failure. Through mindful meditation, it causes and brings occurrence and coordination with various functions of the brain, various parts of the brain. So whatever decision you take, you will take with awareness, then you will be always successful. It harmonizes our endocrine system, relaxes our nervous system, produces lasting beneficial changes in the brain electrical activity, may help curing infertility. Then there are psychological benefits, like it builds self-confidence. It increases serotonin level, influences mood and behavior. So it's helpful in the hopelessness and depression. Okay, it resolves phobia, obsessive compulsive disorder, fear. It helps control own thoughts, help with focus and concentration, increases the creativity, increases the brainwave coherence, improve the learning ability and memory. It's found that those who do mindful meditation, their prefrontal cortex, their hippocampus size increases, their anterior cingulate cortex, the size increases. So their insular size also increases. And this is very helpful for the awareness and for memory and taking good decision. It increases the emotional stability, improved relationship at home and work, and increased job satisfaction. It helps to develop intuition, sixth sense, okay? Help you to see the larger picture in given situation. I have told you, if you think through the mind, you have a very narrow vision, okay? And you will think through the narrow vision and you will be always stressful and unsuccessful. But if you have the whole bigger picture, then it will be achieved with mindful meditation. It helps to develop willpower, decrease the potential for mental disease like anxiety, depression, decrease aggressiveness, anger, frustration, helps to cure insomnia, decrease the tendency to worry, increase empathy. It helps to develop stable and more balanced personality. Now there are a lot of spiritual benefits. Mind you, the mindful meditation is practiced and developed from Lord Buddha. Okay, he attained the Buddhatva, that enlightenment, through this meditation. The main purpose is enlightenment, okay? But we can utilize for leading healthy and happy life, and the next purpose can be enlightenment. So also the meditation provides peace of mind, happiness. It brings body, mind, spirits in harmony. It helps to discover the purpose of life, deeper understanding of yourself and other, and self-actualization. It helps to learn forgiveness. Forgiveness, not only other people and ourselves. So as somebody has asked how to forgive ourselves, do mindful meditation and you will learn the forgiveness. Create deeper relationship with your higher power and deity. And last but not least, it helps to attain the most important thing is enlightenment. So dear friend, to summarize, the mindfulness is living in a present moment, be aware of the present moment, forgetting about the past, not worrying about the future, living a life in a non-judgmental way. And you can practice with mindful meditation. So mindful meditation is practice just closing your eyes, observing your breath at nostril, air coming in and air going out. When you are in thoughts, bringing back your attention at your nostril, that's the mindful meditation. And you are doing and learning this mindfulness and implementing in your day-to-day activity, maybe eating, sleeping, walking, your professional life, your relation. Each and every moment can be become mindful meditation. And if you do the mindful meditation, it will completely transform your life. Thank you so much for your kind attention. And now I'm going to open this forum for question and answer session and for your insight about today's session. I hope you have got golden nuggets. If write in the chat box, what are you learning? Write in the chat box. So Rajesh ji has asked, how do we best use it during our interaction with the patients and what tips can we advise them? What benefits have you found in a personal experience, and being a doctor is a stressful life and with added stress of contracting COVID now? Thank you so much. So the purpose of conducting this mindful meditation session is because of this challenging time. We all are stressed because of this corona pandemic and we don't know how to deal with it. And we have to deal not only at a physical level, but as well as mental level. Because if you are mentally strong, you would be able to navigate this challenging time. So the anticipation also creates a lot of stress, whether I'm going to get corona, what will happen if I get corona. This anticipation, this stress will reduce with the help of mindful meditation. Then if you get corona, if you do mindful meditation, if you're lying down, then you will get the mental strength, your immunity will boost, and you will navigate that challenging time. Okay, so mindful meditation will help not only to deal with the stress, job loss, but to navigate if you contract the disease itself. Because that when you go get the disease, you are hopeless, you are a lot of stress and anxiety, and you can deal with doing mindful meditation. Rajesh ji, it has completely transformed my personal life. Okay, I'm doing the mindful meditation daily. If I don't find a time, then whenever I get a time while doing it, I do it for 2 minutes, 5 minutes. Then when I come back home, I do it at home. And when I go to sleep, I just do mindful meditation and go to sleep. Okay. So it has completely transformed my life. And you can teach this mindful meditation. I teach to my patients to do mindful meditation because there's so much of stress. There's so much of behavioral problem in the children. Also, I teach the parent to do mindful meditation. So if you set the example to your children, your children will start doing my meditation and they will develop an inner discipline. So I teach to the patients also to do mindful meditation and they just like it. Vivek Sharma, as a coach, this technique is absolutely essential, very supportive of enhanced effectiveness in anything kind. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Vivek. Yes, it's very essential. It is a very essential life tool. If you have this tool, you can navigate this turbulence of the life and you can navigate quite well. Thank you so much. Write your question and I'm going to see this question and answer things now. Kishore ji has said, understood the concept. Thank you so much. Kishore ji has said, can you once again describe how we can practice it for sleep? Yeah. So when you go to bed, you have to follow the same step. Just observe your breath. Air coming in, air going out, air coming in, air going out. And when your thoughts, you bring back your attention at nostril. And follow this step and you will go to sleep. Now, mind you, if you keep on thinking about what happened every day, then you will not fall asleep. If you try to fall asleep actively, you will not fall asleep. The problem in insomnia is not that they don't get sleep, because they actively try to fall asleep. The sleep has to come passively. So if you go to bed, you lie down and you do this, observing your breath at nostril, and when you are not in thoughts, you will fall asleep. And when I do my this mindful meditation, when I go to bed, I fall asleep very easily. Okay, so I hope Kishore ji have understood it. Then followed sleep has to come passively. Yes, when you do it mindfully, you just, your sleep will become mindful meditation, and when you get up in the morning, you would be totally re-energized and you will be successful in your life. Write your comments, your question now in a chat box. Now this forum is open for question and answer. Write in the chat box, everybody, what are your take of, and I want your commitment that you're gonna practice and you're gonna utilize this mindfulness in each and every moment of your life. Okay, write in the chat box, how did you find this session? Kishore ji, the great useful session, will use it. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, because it gives immense pleasure that you are useful for somebody else. It's gonna some useful and bring a transformation in other people's life. And I want your commitment that you're gonna use it, you're gonna practice it, and you are going to teach it to your family member, your friends. Okay, so this is a mission. I'm on a mission to inspire 2 million people to achieve holistic health. And I have started this mission. I'm conducting my weekly webinar. If you want to register, you can contact me. I'm giving my email in the chat box. Just note it down. Okay, so if you have any doubt, you can contact me on this email. I'm gonna write down my mobile number as well. If you have any doubt, if you want to learn anything more about your health, you can contact me in this email. You can contact me anytime about anything, and you can email me. I will send you link about the next session, which I'm going to conduct next Monday on anti-aging. Okay, so who want to live youthful forever? Forever means till you take your last breath, you want to remain youthful. Youthful may not be to the body, youthful is to the mind, to your activity. Those who want to remain youthful till your last breath, join me on the next session on anti-aging, how to remain youthful forever. Okay, so just contact me on this email and this phone number, and I'll send you the link. Give me 1 minute. Somebody has come. Just give me 1 minute. So now I'm gonna discuss about my community. Again, I'm sharing the screen. Okay, so I was also started a health and happiness community. The code of honor of this community is, it depends on upon certain principle. The first principle is holistic health. The member in this community try to attain holistic health in each and every sphere of life, personal, social, professional, spiritual. They not only attain the holistic health, but they guide their family to attain the same. The second principle is mindfulness and awareness, which we have learned today. The member in my community try to live the life in the present moment, accept the life as it in a non-judgmental way. Try to change the things you can change and accept the things you cannot change. So you should have a courage to change the things which you can change. And if you do not change, then accept in a non-judgmental way. The third is environmental protection. The member plays to protect the environment by saving water, maintaining cleanliness and avoiding pollution of the environment in whatever way possible. The next principle is leadership. Okay, change starts with me. Okay, I try to change myself, not other people. Okay, and because if I change, I being in a transformation, I can set an example to other people and other people can take inspiration and they can change their life. I'm a torchbearer of the society. The next principle is Kaizen. Kaizen means continuous daily improvement. Okay, the member try to learn new thing each and every day, implement the good things and then disseminate and teach other people. So Kaizen, so the member in my community is in competition with themselves, not with other people. And they strive to become better person today as compared to yesterday. And they believe taking action. They are action oriented. And the last principle is contribution to society. The members try to contribute in whatever possible way to the society. It may be money, it may be knowledge, it may be time and skill. The way I'm contributing to the society. So why I started this community? I told you 5 years back, my life was in a mess. I was completely stressed and burnt out. I had put on 10 kg of weight. I was looking much older than my chronological age. Then I read hundreds of books on spirituality, self-help, holistic book. Then I implemented, I jot down certain principle. I implemented and it completely transformed my life. I lost 10 kg of weight. My work efficiency improved. My relationship with my partner, my family improved. My relationship with my colleague improved. And I started enjoying the life. So I start on a mission to inspire 2 million people to achieve holistic health so that they can lead healthy, happy and more fulfilling life. So I have conducted many seminars and webinars for various organizations, various colleges, and many people has transformed their life by attending these seminars, webinars. Okay, this is my book, which has become international bestseller, Oh Stress, Give Me a Break. Again, I have recently published this book, 17 Powerful Secrets to Manage Stress During Corona Pandemic. So my journey was like this. I was navigating life, then I fall down this valley. Then I learned by reading thousands and thousands of books and I got out of this valley. Okay. But I won't help people to navigate this valley because this may take years. And if you have experience of other people, you can take the experience, you can take how they have navigated this valley, then other people may not have to fall this valley. Or if they have to fall this valley, it may be of a short duration. So I want to help the people as a bridge to navigate this valley by sharing whatever principle I have learned. So who should join my community? If you are stressed, if you have chronic disease like obesity, diabetes, hypertension, heart disease, cancer, mental disease, and want to reverse this disease. If you do not want this disease to enter in your life, if you want to lose weight and reverse diabetes, if anybody in your family is having chronic disease, if you want to age healthy without disease and spending lack of money on popping pill, do you think that you are the most unhappy and unsuccessful person on earth? Do you think that there are other modality of treatment which is health oriented and not disease oriented? If you're a doctor and want to treat your patient in a holistic way, do you want to succeed in your life and climb the corporate ladder and be successful in your business? Because if you're healthy, then you can focus in your professional life and your efficiency will increase exponentially. If you want to have a healthy relationship with your partner, want to become healthy, happy, and more fulfilling life, then join my community. And a lot of people has benefited from this community. So If you want to join my community, you can contact me by sending email. I have sent the email on a chat box. Send the email. We can have a Zoom call and then we can discuss how you can become a part of my community. Okay. Thank you, Rajeshji. Any session possible on Sunday or the session recorded? Thanks. Didn't see your email in chat box. Thanks. So again, I'm going to write down the email in the chat box. So can you see your email? You got the email in chat box? Email, you can see the chat box. Email and number. Email, I have written again, I will write down the number. So I have last many webinars I conducted on Sunday, but today I conducted because I had some work on Sunday. So in future, I may conduct this in Sunday also. Okay. So be in touch with me. Okay. You send me email. You got my email. You got my number. This is in chat box. Say yes if you got my email. Just see the chat box. D. So I'll write. One second, the panelists and attendees. Okay. Sorry. It was. So you got this email now? You got it? Sorry, it was on other mode, only panelists. Thank you for reminding me. You got my email now? Email and number. So dear friends, it was honor, pleasure and privilege having such an interactive colleague in this webinar. I hope you have enjoyed today's session. Saint Kabir has said, when Kabir, the Saint Kabir sees his life, and then he says, because we are just living our life. The Saint Kabir was viewer. So whatever things he tells with his life's example. And he says, the people live their life in ignorance. And that's why there's so much of stress and anxiety. If you live this life with awareness, because we are the trustee of our body, we are not the owner of our body. If we live our life with awareness and give this body in the same way the God has given, then we would be successful as a human being. Kabir said, "Jini jini binre chadariya, jini jini binre chadariya, kahe katana kahe ki bhani, kon tar se bini chadariya." साई सीवत दसमा लागे ठोक ठोक के बिनी चदरिया सोवत चादर सुर नुरमनी ओढ़े ओढ़ी की मैली कर दिनी चदरिया दास कबीर जतन से ओढ़ी जो की त्यों धर दिनी चदरिया द सेंट कबीर सेज व्हेन ही सीज हिज बॉडी इट्स अ मिरेकल द बॉडी हैज बीन क्रिएटेड बाय गॉड इन अ मिरेकुलस वे. You can see it's a miracle. You can hear it's a miracle. Okay, you can take the breathing is a miracle. So, Saint Kabir says, when you have to view a very delicate chadar, you have to have a lot of awareness and concentration. Jini jini binirechadariya. God, you have created this body with so much of taking so much of delicate things in your consideration. Jini jini binirechadariya kahe katana kahe ki bhani kon tar se binirechadariya. How did you produce this miraculous body? Sai siyat dasma lage thok thok ke binirechadariya. 10 means it's a 10 months in the older times. So he says ki you have created this body with so much of efforts. Sovat chadar sur nur mani ode ode ki maili kar deni chadariya. Sovat means in ignorance. He says sovat chadar sur means the demon, nar means the human being, and sur is demon and nar means the god and muni is the saint. Sovat chadar sur nur mani odi odi ki maili kar deni chadariya. Those whoever lead this life in ignorance, they waste this life. Das Kabir jatan se odi jo ki tyo dhar dini chadariya. But Saint Kabir has lived this life with jatan, awareness, and I am giving this life to you the way I have received you. So dear friends, live this life with awareness and give your life when you take a last breath the way you have received the life. This is my last message. Thank you so much, all of you, for being here. Thank you so much. Be in touch. I've given you your email. Thank you so much. Write in the chat box how you're feeling now. We are gonna just close this session now. Write in the chat box how was the session. Kishore, thank you so much. Super. Thank you so much for your feedback, sir. It is very honor and privilege and pleasure having all of you here. Thank you so much. Write in the chat box how did you learn and what you learned in this session. Keep in touch to the email, send me email. Be there every week. I am conducting this webinar. Be there. Thank you so much, Batulji. Very nice. Thank you so much for your feedback. Write your feedback. Thank you so much, all dear friends. I'm ending this session. Thank you so much. I pray for your health, happiness, prosperity, your family's health. May God help all human beings navigate this challenging time, emerge victorious, all remain healthy, happy, and prosperous. Thank you so much. Cheers. God bless you.